رب العالمين. الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت. الحمد لله ذي الفضل والكرم ذي القدرة والنعم. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you will believe, fear Allah as he should be feared, and they not accept on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gift us the gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya arhamar rahimeen. Amma ba'd, Ibrahim alayhi salam, al-Khalil, the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Halim, the one who's forbearing, al-Awwahu, the one who's returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his way, that he's always thinking and remembering Allah. Imam Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him to be imam for the whole nation. Here Ibrahim making a dua in the surah that we are mentioning some of the ayat to revisit the concept of the trust in Allah. When we found out from Surah Ibrahim that the trust in Allah is the perseverance, the firmness of the deen, and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the help and the strength to have patience to face the trial of this dunya and to gain the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill the travel to Allah in this life to be safe and gain his pleasure subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the ultimate goal for the believer, and that's the meaning of the success Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he provided for us and he explained it for us. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lived all his life in a state of striving to explain to us this in our mind and to have it as a way of thinking and a way of doing and a way of action. And the most important thing for the believer to be aware of what he's doing. Therefore, the most important thing is his way of thinking to be in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, toward the same surah that we were visiting, or we were trying to get some lesson of it, which is Surah Ibrahim, he is alayhi salam making dua. Behold, Ibrahim turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said, Rabbi ij'al hadha al-balada amina wa junubni wa baniya an na'bud al-asnam. O Allah, make this town, this balda, this city to be a city of safety or security, which is the city of Mecca, and the city of Mecca as long as it is safe, and the Muslim they travel to it to fulfill the Hajj, it will be the standing point for the whole humankind, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, جَعَلَ اللَّهُ الْكَعْبَةَ الْحَرَامَ قِيَامًا لِلنَّاسِ. Allah made the Kaaba, the house that is forbidden, and sacred house, the standing of life and the standing for the life of the humankind on this earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibrahim alayhi salam, continuing in this dua, and he said, وَجْنُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَنْ نَعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ. O Allah, preserve me. O Allah, keep me away. O Allah, protect me from worshipping the idols. From worshipping the idols. And the question that someone will ask Ibrahim al-Khalil, Ibrahim, the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after these long, long years of submission, of being himself the only one who is believer and Muslim, and then his wife was believer with him, and Lut alayhi salam accepted Islam, but he was the one who facing the whole nation, and himself alayhi salam who was the whole nation. Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitan lillahi hanifa wa lam yakun min al-mushrikeen. Ibrahim alayhi salam himself, he scared to fall under the temptation, under the trial, under the fitna of worshipping asnam, the fitna of worshipping idols. And the question is how Ibrahim alayhi salam asking such a question when himself who broke the idol, when he said he know that the idol they cannot speak, the idol they cannot even think, the idol they don't benefit, the idol they don't have any power to harm or to give benefit to anyone. And here a reflection for us called by in the Quran to see the depth of the answer or the asking of Ibrahim alayhi salam. The idols are statues, the idols are things that are created by the mind, created by people themselves. So here, al-asnam, if you are talking about as idols, it's not the idol that they existed in time of Quraysh. One of them is called Hubal, and the one of them, the other girl, Manat, wal-Uzza, wal-Lati. Or in the time of Ibrahim, one of them is named Marduk, and one of them, whatever name they give, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, in hiya illa asma'un sammaytumuha ma anzalallahu biha min sultan. His name is that you gave to this idol, and you associate to them belief, you associate to them things that they do not have. Therefore, the reality of the idols, if to implement it and you understand of the dua of Ibrahim, to protect ourselves and to protect our children and our families, it is the idea itself. It's not the idol that it is the form of the idol. In the idea of the idols, when someone has an idea that he attaches his motivation, his dreams, his expectation, his purpose of life, that's in the idol. When someone builds for himself a dream, and he thinks, for example, a business is going to solve all the problem, or a high position is going to give him all the happiness that everyone is seeking, that it becomes an idol. And the most awkward part, that his own prayer that he's doing to Allah becomes serving that idol. He's praying because he wants that. He's making Qiyam al-Layl because he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that particular thing. So he's fully and completely driven by that ambition, driven by the dream, that his only dream is going to be fulfilled in this dunya, and after he gets it, he will not find anything, because the reality that someone is seeking the way of the dunya, he will be running behind the dunya all the time. And this is Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he say, وَجْنُبْنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَن نَعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ. Ya Allah, protect us, preserve us from this false idea that creating ourselves idols, because people today say that doesn't exist Hubal, there is no any idol in Mecca, there is no any idol in the Kaaba, the Prophet ﷺ destroyed them. But the idol that they exist in our heart, they exist in our mind. So the most terrible thing for the believer is to have a way of thinking that it really take him away from the path of Allah without even sensing it or knowing it. Why? Because he put all his goal, all his motivation, all his attachment to something that is distant from the way of Allah. And it is in this society and the world of today is kind of known. People that are targeting, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the example of leaders, but leaders that they call, they're not calling for the right path. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he's calling for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah make him imam, the leader and the imam for the nation, calling for the way of the truth. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the messenger of the rahmah, calling for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned also imam. So imam is not only in the good, there's imam who calling for the hellfire. He made Fir'aun, the way of Fir'aun, to be imam. قَالَ وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ. Allah made Fir'aun as in the way of his doing, the way he was striving and rejecting all the type of the miracles that being provided to him by Musa alayhi salam, he rejected them because of his arrogance, because of the love of the life that he has, and he was mocking Musa, how he was looking at Musa. Looking at Musa as someone who doesn't have the luxury that Fir'aun has. He doesn't have the power that Fir'aun he has. He said, when he talking about Musa, قَالَ لَوْلَا أُلْقِيَ عَلَيْهِ أَسْوِرَةٌ مِّنْ ذَهَبٍ. If he has at least some bracelet of gold to come talk to us, but he's coming like with these worn-out clothes, how can he even want to talk or he stand in front of me? So the way of Fir'aun, the way he was doing, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cast him to be punished and drowned in the sea, his way is way for those leading to the hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is a way of Fir'aun, is an idea, is a way who create in the self an idol to be worshipped. So the one who's looking forward to have a high position in the earth, to have a position of power, to control other people, that in itself is named idol. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Qarun, all his money that he had, the wealth for him, it was an idol. Ubay ibn Khalaf, it was the
Tijara, the business for him was an idol. Therefore, when we're talking about today's world, even in the society when they do not have any statue that they worship, like you know, in some part of the Asia, in India or in the Far East, all of these people, they have idols. But when we're talking about around here or around in our country, there is no idol, but the reality of the idol exists. Actually, many of us, they might have idols. And the Prophet ﷺ was warning us about ash-shirk al-khafi, the hidden shirk. What is the hidden shirk? It's the hidden to associate partner with Allah. So the scholar, they explain it with the showing off. But more than the showing off, everything that your heart is attached to, everything that you believe is going to give you success, everything that you're feeling is attached to, that you feel success is coming from that corner, that is an idol. If it's not blessed in the way of Allah, if it's not in the way of Allah, is not, if it's not leading to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the way of Ibrahim teaching us. And he said, alayhi salam, فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي فَأَنَّهُ مِنْ Ya Allah, who holds, follow me, who will make his way of thinking, that thinking has a great purpose within the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفِيرٌ رَحِيمٌ To see the mercy of Ibrahim, he said, whoever who reject this faith, whoever who disobey me, Ya Allah, you are the oft forgiven, the most merciful. Which means Ibrahim, he will never give up to call people for Islam, to call people for guidance. And Ya Allah, if they do today disobey, they will have another opportunity to see maybe with the common sense how Islam is beautiful. And if they come to you, Ya Allah, you always will be the oft forgiven, the most merciful to forgive them. Now for ourselves, when we're talking about this idol, about these ideas, there's a lot of ideas outside. There's a lot of people calling for any other types of success, and our youth, our people, ourselves will be really attractive with this type of this idea. People, it's really having money is a great thing. It solves all the problems for some people. Having like a great position is everything for some people. Having, you know, to fight and get great degree is all of it is great. But when you put that in the purpose of the life, that's where awkwardness enters in the way and deviation start to be in the path of the believer, and he will be sliding away till he will not find himself in the masjid at all. Why? Because he don't feel it anyway. He doesn't feel that he need to pray. He doesn't feel that he need to fast. Why? Because what he was looking for, he has it in his hand. And this is how the sliding away starts in the life of the believer. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, wajnubni wa baniya an na'bud al-asnam. Oh Allah, preserve us, take us away to not fall into this illusion of idea that is really telling us is a great success when it is not the only success in the pleasure of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال يدخل المؤمنين والمؤمنات جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ويكفر عنهم سيئاتهم. To have enter the believer, man and woman, and he will expiate all their sins. And what he said, وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. That is the great success according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the believer thinking of that, how he will protect himself to not fall into this type of, or he will let himself slide away with this really beautiful idea outside. Everyone wants to have money. That's a great thing. You can have it in halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال نعم المال الصالح عند الرجل الصالح. Great is the great fortune, the great wealth in the hand of the righteous man. So you will be double rewarded with living yourself. If you want luxury, that's halal, that's tayyibat. But for someone to set his mind on the accumulation, he will fall on the nest of the shaitan by seeking the fahsha. الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. الشيطان he's threatening you. Poverty is by your door. Shaitan, he said, telling you, if tomorrow you open your door, you're going to be poor. So just accumulate to have your stuff, you reserve your accumulation. يأمركم بالفحشاء. He's ordering you to do a lot, to accumulate a lot, to do everything out of boundaries, beyond its boundaries. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضل. And Allah is ordering you or promising you his forgiveness. Just come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way that the believer, he need to think, as we extracted from the book of Allah, to not fall into the nest of the shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you, if you look at the people outside, those are totally astray, those who have their idea and they market marketing their idea for all of us and mainly our youth or those dreamers to fall into their nest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants us to think of something great, of a certainty that no one can change. But the problem, we are heedless about this certainty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do you see all this oppressor, all this unjust? And when we say unjust, it's not only the tyrant who kills with no right, that he's an oppressor and unjust. The one who using the money to spend it for mischief and fulfill his low desire, he's an unjust. And the one who is doing sins and fighting Allah with his own sins also is an unjust. How the picture of the unjust will be in the day of judgment? That's what Allah wants us to know. So someone, when you see all the success and we say illusion is like a mirage, is what you see, it's reality, but is not the truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Don't think that Allah is unaware of those oppressors, what they are doing. Don't think. So if you see this idea that is attractive, but is in reality is an illusion because it doesn't lead you to the pleasure of Allah, think that that one, or if you will be among them, you will be in this image. فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ إِنَّمَا يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ لِيَوْمٍ تَشْخَصُ فِيهِ الْأَبْصَارِ. He's postponed them to a day when the glaze will be staring. Subhanallah. And this is, as I said, is a certainty, is a reality. For the believer, he needs to build it as a certainty. And I said, as certain as he sees the sun in the mid of the day, in the heart of the sky. That's what Allah is inviting us to think when you read the Quran. These people ingest how they come in the day of judgment. شَخِصَةً أَبْصَارُهُمْ. Their eyes is staring. مُهْطِعِينَ. They're following a color, which is the color of Allah for the meeting. مُهْطِعِينَ رُؤُوسَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال مُهْطِعِينَ مُقْنِعِي رُؤُوسِهِمْ. Their head is stretched out. Why? Because the heart is in the throat from the fear and the terror of this day. مُهْطِعِينَ مُقْنِعِي رُؤُوسِهِمْ لَا يَرْتَدُّ إِلَيْهِمْ طَرْفُهُمْ. They cannot blink. It's because of that day, terrified day, they don't even blink, staring. مُقْنِعِي رُؤُوسِهِمْ لَا يَرْتَدُّ إِلَيْهِمْ طَرْفُهُمْ وَأَفْئِدَتُهُمْ هَوَى. With vacant, empty hearts. Certainty, dear brother, respected sister, every oppressor, every unjust will have this image in the day of judgment. You choose for yourself. فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ. Don't think that Allah is unaware. Don't let the shaitan distract you. Don't let the shaitan make you fall into nest to see the success outside. Eat the success. It is an illusion. It is a mirage, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah قال كَبِقِيعَةٍ يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمْآنُ مَاءً. كَبِقِيعَةٍ is like a plant desert. So the one who thirsty, he thinks that is a water. When he comes to it, he doesn't find anything. As Allah قال كَرَمَادٍ اشْتَدَّتْ بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي يَوْمٍ عَاصِفٍ. It's like dust, it's like ashes. When it comes strong wind, it takes everything. So we will not find anything in your hand. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brushing for us, painting for us this really scene to see every oppressor, that every true believer and every one of us, he doesn't want to be like that in the day of judgment. He doesn't want to be to have this situation. He doesn't want to have this image. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned to the Prophet, قَالَ وَأَنذِرِ النَّاسَ يَوْمَ يَأْتِيهِمُ الْعَذَابِ. And warn mankind the day when the punishment will come. The punishment will come. It's not you going to be thrown in the punishment. The come is coming to you. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. وأنذر warn. And here I want to stop a small stop to understand for us the meaning warn. Warning as a priority in the Sharia, it has higher priority than the prayer that we observe and we offer. Because what is the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? قال يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا. Oh, you Prophet, we have sent you as a witness on the whole mankind. ومبشرات, to bear the glad tidings for the believer. ونذيرا is to warn the day of judgment. وداعيا إلى الله, and to call to Allah. So they travel to Allah by fasting and praying and doing this. So if someone will not put the priority of thinking and projecting and planning based on the warning that Allah warned us, therefore your salat will be empty. Your fasting will not have a reason. Why? Because you're praying for what? If you have an engine to really give you that motivation, you are hoping for the mercy of Allah and you want to shield yourself. If you do not know what is awaiting us in the day of judgment, so our prayer will not have khushu'. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing the salihin, قَالَ تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ. Their sights are forsaken from their beds. Why? They cannot sleep because they thinking of the indar, when the punishment will come, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. يَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ السَّمَاءُ بِالْغَمَامِ وَنُزِّلَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ تَنْزِيلًا. الملك يومئذ الحق للرحمن وكان يوما على الكافرين عسيرا. When the sky will split asunder and will be all filled with cloud, and when the angel will be coming down, that's in the day of the truth, the king in the hand of the most merciful Allah. And it is a very difficult day for the disbeliever. كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا وجيء يومئذ بجهنم. It's a day, it's a certain, when the earth will crumble into pieces and when Allah will come in His great majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala and the angel in rows. What? Where do you want to be at that moment? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuing this beautiful ayah to tell ourselves that the warning is a part of our belief, is a warning, is a part of our daily worship. Inna arsalnaka, in Surah Al-Fath, inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhir. So, O Ya Rasulullah, we send you a witness and to bearer of glad tidings, وَنَذِيرَ, a warner. Now, this message of the Prophet, لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ وَتُسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. لِلسَّبَبِيَّ. So what is before it, it is the illa, the reason, to for us to believe in Allah, to believe in the Prophet, to follow the way of the Prophet, and to celebrate the praises of Allah day and night. Why? Because of al-bisharatu wal-indhar. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala wa anzir, if we will not include in our daily worship the thinking and the planning of our idea based on that day, we will have the image of those transgressors when they come, muhti'ina muqni'i ru'usihim la yartaddu ilayhim tarfuhum wa afidatuhum hawa. Then, ikhwani, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us other thing. Don't think that Allah is not going to fulfill the promise of His prophets. Again, to feed our trust in Allah, to feed and strengthen our confidence in Allah. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said after this ayat, and we don't have the time to go through all the ayat. قَالَ فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ مُخْلِفَ وَعْدِهِ رُسُلَهُ. Don't ever think that Allah is not going to fulfill the promise of His prophet. Don't. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ Allah is the Almighty. ذُو انتِقَامٍ The Lord of Retribution. That day, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضُ The day when the earth will be changed to another earth. It will be flat, white, and straight. كما قال النبي أرض المحشر أرض بيضاء نقية. No sin was committed on this land. يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات and different totally heaven around you and the angels surrounding وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار. And you come and all before Allah, the Lord, the Supreme, the Irresistible, the One, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَرِ بَرَزُوا, you cannot hide anything. It's not time to be ashamed from Allah. It's too late. If someone has the sense of shyness, it's today that he needs to build it. When he be doing a sin, thinking that Allah is not seeing him because he is locked behind doors, Allah is watching you. It's better for us to think of being shy from Allah before the day that you cannot hide anything. رَفِيعُ الدَّرَجَاتِ ذُو الْعَرْشِ يُلْقِ الرُّوحَ عَلَى مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ لِيُنْذِرَ يَوْمَ التَّلَاقِ Toward the day of the meeting. يَوْمَ هُمْ بَارِزُونَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْهُمْ شَيْءٍ The day they will be all apparent. No one can hide from Allah. And Allah will say, لِمَنُ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ To whom the kingdom today? You already belong to Allah. And you testify today that you belong to Allah. And you come at the day you are the property of Allah. And it is a day for us to remind us to not fall into the nest of the asnam, to not fall in the nest of the idea to create our own idols and to run behind an illusion, but to remind of ourselves of this day. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلْ Read it, أخوان. Dear brother, respected sister, this is a reminder for myself and for all my dear brother and respected sister. We are in a time, a difficult time, a lot of fitna. We are in a people that they are so heated, they making out of their celebration idols like today. There's the story of Halloween with all these roots of paganism and all what you see around. If we don't stand to remind ourselves, we are creating our own idols without knowing by even sympathizing of such a thing. We don't hate anyone, but we hate the action because it's leading us astray from Allah. Think, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرُ الْأَرْضُ When you change the land and you'll be in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where do you want to be? Where do you want to be? We want to be in the mercy of Allah. اللهم اجعلنا في رحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد الله سبحانه وتعالى جل في عليائه يقسم والطور وكتاب مسطور في رق منشور والبيت المعمور والسقف المرفوع والبحر المسجور All this قسم the first the tour by the mountain from where Allah سبحانه وتعالى called موسى And by the book that being in scripture and being spread, and by the house that is the most visited, it is in Al-Ma'mur for the angel and on the earth for the Kaaba. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the ceiling that is lifted which is the sky, and the bahar that is filled with all what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in it. All this, wa wa turi Allah qasam, to say, inna azaba rabbika lawaqa. The punishment of Allah is going to happen. مَا لَهُ مِنْ دَافَعٍ No one can stop it. عُمَر رضي الله تعالى عنه riding back from صلاة العشاء to his home, one of the companions, he's reading in his house and he's listening. وَالطُّور is a qasam. Allah is swearing. And continue the third, the second, when he said, إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ بِالتَّوْكِيد إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقِعٌ The punishment of Allah is going to occur. He fell, رضي الله تعالى. He could not stand it. He fell. That's the type of the believer that we're seeking to have in our system, not to be scared from the punishment, but to be aware for it to be part of our way of thinking, projecting and planning. And he stayed, رضي الله تعالى, for weeks being visited because he's sick. People, they do not know why he's sick. It was that ayah. The impact, the effect of إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقَعْ فِي قَلْبِ عُمَرٍ, in the heart of Umar, make him to be for all this time sick. And many of us, we read it without even noticing what he's talking about. But ikhwani, the greatest thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us, it is paradise. It is paradise. Let's include it in our daily dua. If you ask for a provision, Allah guarantee it for you. Wallahi, Allah guarantee it for everything to live, inshaAllah. Just be in iman, Allah give you joyful life. Allah promise. Allah promise. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ قَالَ مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَأُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. Whoever who do good deeds, male or female, and he's a believer, I make him live a joyful life. But we ask Allah the Jannah because that's what Allah, the greatest thing that he promised us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he fulfilled his promise. As he said, لَهُمْ فِيهَا مَا يَشَاءُونَ خَالِدِينَ كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ وَعْدًا مَسْئُولًا. It was a promise from Allah that we ask for it. And we ask, Ya Allah, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مَا وَعَدْتَنَا عَلَىٰ رُسُلِكَ. And the angel are asking this for us. رَبَّنَا وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ الَّتِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ. Oh Allah, have them to enter the Jannat Adn that you promised us. Ya Allah, you promised us Jannah. Ya Allah, help us to grant us the strength to have the saying and the action that take us to the Jannah. اللهم اجعلنا متقين. اللهم اجعلنا متوكلين. اللهم اجعلنا منيبين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.